Hello everyone, I'm Qsan and today I'm very happy to share my first talks about the new Clip Studio Paint version 3.0. This is a huge update with many new functions, so why don't I try my favorites out with a drawing? Let's get started! First, open Clip Studio Paint on PC. As you can see, Start has an updated interface with a minimal and intuitive design. On the homepage, you have your news, suggestions, questions, materials, and social media feeds. On the left, you can find your projects, account information, materials, and the activation code page. Clicking the draw icon, you'll have access to the art program. Create a new canvas. Let's start with the character pose. For this, we can now take advantage of the new collaboration with Pose Maniacs, one of the most popular art sites for royalty-free pose references. With 3.0, you can import poses that you are interested in and apply them to 3D drawing models. Go into menu, File, Import, 3D Pose Pose Maniacs, choose the one you need. I decided to use this one to draw my character in a traditional outfit. It feels like a good pose to try out the features I'll show you later. Then, click the Open Clip Studio Paint blue button. After picking the 3D model type, the pose is automatically uploaded on your canvas. If you need to access a specific stage of your drawing, Layer Comp is the feature for you. If you have X, you can organize your layer compositions and save them in the same project. To activate it, go to Menu, Window, Layer Comp. Click the bottom right second icon to create a new comp. Change the name as you prefer. Then, save the current layer structure by clicking the Save Layer Comp icon, the third one from the bottom right. I can create as many comps as I like. For example, you can save the layer compositions for different backgrounds, outfits, color solutions, and more. Now let's see if we can add some details. Some of the new features can improve your colors or add special effects. The first one is the color match. With it, I can adjust color tones using images or gradients. Choose a layer. Then, go to Menu, Edit, Tonal Correction, Color Match. I'll get different color match that fits the image preview in the box. I can also upload my image or change the main source and choose a standard or a custom gradient. If necessary, edit the intensity value to adjust the effect. For a stronger result, uncheck Maintain Brightness. After trying different color match results, I decided to keep this combination and continue working on it. Going to Menu, Filter, Effect, I can find some new often requested filters such as Pencil Drawing. This effect emphasizes lines and makes the image look more like a sketch. You can get both fine and thick lines and choose what will match your art style. Retrofilm which gives your look a vintage look. Editing the value enhances the contrast and noise. Going to the effect menu, I can access various effects that gives the filter more or less of a vintage look. Chromatic aberration is similar to the retro film, but the blur and the split colors are stronger, which is helpful when adding dynamism to the scene for enhancing the character's emotions. The noise effect is perfect for applying a rough texture to the drawing. This is very helpful for traditional style artworks, giving the canvas a slight paper look. You can choose a color mode or a gray one. After testing their values, my personal favorite is the pencil drawing effect. I really love the final result and how the color became more pastelish, emphasizing the outline and the crosshatch. I really appreciate the retro film too, since it enriches the final result with little vintage touches. Do you remember the circular window background? Let's go work on it using the text tools. With a new compatibility option for Western comics with contextual alternates, my favorite updates are clips to the comic, a new comic font type is ready for personal and commercial projects, and circular text, an option to place text along any circular diameter. You can increase or decrease the radius and change the direction of the text, clockwise or counterclockwise. Checking the space evenly, you can close the text better around the diameter without leaving any space. With this specific option, I decorate the window using different fonts and the CPS slogan. Done! What do you think of these new features? Of course there are more, but these for me are giving me new ideas for future drawings. I can't wait to show you them again with proper examples, specifically in a watercolor style, and why not? Maybe I can try out the mobile devices where shortcuts have been added specifically for CPS simple mode, which I've been really enjoying. It's now possible to use an external keyboard or the tab mate and set up your favorite commands by going to the three dots, preferences and help, keyboard shortcuts, or Clip Studio tab mate 2. Thank you very much for watching this video, I hope it gives you some inspiration and ideas too. Don't hesitate to share your feedback with us, we can wait to see your art.
Clip Studio Paint.